Hello friends, this is your professor Samir Sheikh. I am assistant professor at NB Navales Sihinger College of Engineering Solapur. My specialization is in CAD/CAM and automation. So we are going to discuss the unit number 7, which is tooling for CNC machines in our subject CAD/CAM and CAE. In the previous session we have discussed about the what is the tool magazine basically, and what are different types of tool magazines that have been working or that have been placed nowadays in modern CNC machines, namely turret type of tool magazine, drum type of tool magazine, and chain type of tool magazines are available. In today's session we are going to discuss what is automatic tool changer or what is an automatic tool changing arm. Sometimes it is also called as ATC arm only. Okay, so basically it's a systematic way of changing the tool from the spindle to the tool magazine. Okay, now in the turret type of tool magazine, as we have seen, it is very simple to change the tool as the turret indexes itself. So turret type of tool magazine will not only store the tools, but it itself indexes so that tool change occurs. Okay, generally Geneva mechanism is used for indexing the turret in CNC machines, so we don't required a ATC in such cases. But in drum type and chain type of tool magazine, we do need to have a tool changing arm which will provide the necessary tool transfer. Okay, so the tool magazine is placed basically very close to the spindle. Now when we are talking about tool magazine, drum type or of chain type of tool magazine, these tool magazine have to be placed very close to the spindle of the machine so that tool transfer takes place very quickly. The tool changing time is generally from 2 seconds to 10 seconds only, so it is that fast. You can imagine within 2 seconds and as long as 10 seconds you get the change of tool, okay, from the spindle to the tool magazine. So this is basically the schematic of a tool changing arm with double gripper. So these are two double grippers that are available. That is what is called as double gripper mechanism. There are single gripper mechanism also, that means only one gripper is available. Okay, so in this particular figure what you see is a tool magazine which is shown over here. So this is a chain type of tool magazine. We have a gripper, double gripper, and this is basically a tool changing arm. This is the spindle of the machine where the actual machining procedure will take place. So the tools are coming out of the screen, that means they are perpendicular to the screen, right? So how this basically works, as you can see it's a circle over here, that means the tool changing arm is pivoted at this center and it is going to rotate about this particular center, right? So this is the stepwise procedure in which the tool changing arm will work, right? Let us try to see how this tool changing procedure takes place by a simple video link, then we will discuss what these figures are. So basically what you see over here is a tool magazine. As you can see, number of tools are mounted there, and this is your tool changing arm mechanism. So as you can see here, the tool changing arm is basically at the parking position or the initial position, and this is the spindle end and this is the magazine end. So first this tool changing arm will rotate by 90 degrees so as to grip the tool from the spindle as well as the tool magazine simultaneously like this. Okay, once it grips over here, this will come out by a certain distance and it will rotate by 180 degrees so as to swap the tools from the magazine to the spindle. See, like this. Okay, so once this happens, the tools have been swapped. The tool from the spindle is back to the magazine and the new tool is being placed in the spindle. Once this is done, the ATC will go back to the parking position or to the initial position like this. Okay, so once it is gone to the initial position, the cutting tool which is present at the spindle will do the machining obviously, and this tool which has came back to the magazine will be placed inside the tool magazine. So this tool has been placed inside the tool magazine. Now the tool magazine will give back the new tool which is required for the next operation. So the next tool is ready, and once this is finished machining over here, the ATC will do its job once again. This is how continuously we can change the tool cutting, we can change the cutting tools very easily, and that too at a very faster rate. Okay, this is how the ATC works. So this is what has been shown over here. This is the initial position, at the parking position, at the starting position. Once the operation is finished, it is going to rotate by 90 degrees, okay, like this, and it will swap the tools after rotation of 180 degrees. Then this is the position, the swapping will take place, that means we have to rotate by 180 degrees, and finally it is going back to the parking position, right? So this is how the double gripper arm will work. You can also have a single arm, but the time required for tool change will be larger. As you can imagine, it has to work stepwise. First it has to pick up the tool from the spindle, then rotate back, put it back to the magazine, then the magazine will index, then it will pick up the new tool. So likewise, the time taken to change the tool with a single tool arm is more compared to a double gripper arm. Double gripper arm are more popular as compared to single arm, right? And this is the sequence that we have discussed just now. So you have to go through the sequence one by one and see that this has been written completely in the examination, right? The only thing that you have to consider in such case is that the old tool will be placed into a magazine pocket location. That means the tool from the spindle will be placed in a location which is been vacated by the new tool. So I don't have the exactly same location for all the tools for all particular operations. So it is very necessary to keep track of the tool's location. Which tool is been placed in which pocket, we have to keep the track. So that is the only consideration that has to be taken care while you work with automatic tool changing arm. So that's it for this session. We will see the next part in the next session. Thanks for watching.